Hey, welcome back to Legends Out of Skyward Sword. We're here inside of the Ancient Cistern. This is a water temple, I suppose you want to call it that. I remember seeing this dungeon a while back in the trailer that Nintendo released, and I was really worried, thinking, oh man, water temples is gonna suck, since Nintendo has a thing for making horrible water-themed dungeons. But actually, this is one of the best dungeons in the game. It's really kind of straightforward, but it's filled with a lot of cool new things, and it's really creative. I think this is the spot where Nintendo, well, maybe Onaru mining the province, or this one's where they really start to show their creativity with the dungeons and everything. And it's Onaru mining facility, I mean, not province. Anyways, what we're going to first do is get ourselves a big key. Now, there's a puzzle here in this next room where you have to hit icons on the door in a certain order. I found that out on my own. I actually just kind of like smacked this a bunch, so I figured out. There's a tablet right next to the door that tells you what you need to do, but it's up, down, left, right. That's the order you need to hit these in, and aiming is very precise, so make sure you're doing it the right way. To figure that out on your own, what you need to do is swim around the main structure in the room that we started in, and you will find icons that tell you what order to hit that door. But why do that when I just told you how to do it? I just saved you a bunch of time. So you're welcome. Anyways, that little spider guy was waiting for me. What you need to do is just knock them down by cutting their string or their silk line with the beetle. This one might be too high up, I might not be able to get him yet, so I'm going to go ahead and lower him down before I try and do that. So let's get close to him. Here we go. And I'm gonna kill him. I'm sure PETA would be proud. And bye bye. Now, what you may have seen earlier is that when you jump onto these lily pads, that they flip, and you can uncover a jagged barbed side with like a little spiked hook on it. Those will hurt you, so what we need to do is flip this one, because when you touch it, it does take damage, and Link and I go through it, so we need to get through that. So flip it, and now you can see that there is an underwater area that we can now get to. So just go ahead and spin through all of those. Really nice, got all three at once. And look at that, look at all the skill I've got. It's not even right how much talent I have. So we're going to go ahead, just go on through here, exit, and get ourselves a key, a small key. Alright, so now we have that, we're going to return to the central main room. It's kind of like we'll be returning there throughout this dungeon. It's pretty important, we'll see later on why that is. I just want to get past this guy. He's got a pretty big range. I'm just gonna run past him. Oh, he doesn't want to let me run past him. He wants to keep on hitting me. Not very nice for a guy that I decided to let live. But alright, so let's keep on running. We run past all these guys. And we'll just go. There's a locked door on the middle platform that we're going to get to, so we can just jump onto these. Now, they will not flip because we're not jumping on them from a high enough elevation, so it's not going to put enough pressure on them to flip, so don't worry about that. Alright, as we come in here, we're going to get a cinematic. And it's just going to highlight how tall and deep this room is. And at the very top, we have ourselves the boss chamber with its unique flower-like key. I don't recall that key being all that tough to solve, thankfully. Anyways, drop down and we find ourselves in the boss, or the mini boss fight. This is where we get the dungeon item. We're getting it really quickly on in this dungeon. And it's pretty much just another form of Stalfos. This guy is a little bit easier. Well, it's not easier, it's supposed to be harder, but it's not hard. Pretty much the premise is aim your sword strikes between the two swords you have. You can also use bombs, which I will use bombs at some point in this fight. Because I can't use bombs. Why try to fight him when he's on him? If you stay too close to him, then he will hit you back, so try not to do that. And if you need health, there's plenty of skulls laying around the perimeter with hearts in them. But once you hit him enough times, he'll pull out two more arms with two more gigantic weapons to deal out some massive damage. It's same premise, hit in between, but the thing is he's moving fairly quickly, so he might be lined up, but when you actually heal the swing, he will have moved already, so you'll end up missing. So you can keep hacking away at him, and that's definitely not a problem. But I am just going to use bombs until I run out of them. May as well, it's safer. And you can just drop a bomb, have him get lured to it. That will stun him where you are able to get a couple of hits off. There you go. See, he'll drop all of his weapons. And as soon as you smack him, he'll quickly pick it up. It's impressive how quickly he does. Trying to tie a tie while commentating is not going very well. But that's pretty much the same thing. It's just a repeat thing that we have going on here. If he does hit you, it does do a good amount of damage. But again, just keep your distance, use bombs if you want. Or if you're really good at your sword, go ahead and try and slash him. I will later on just finish him really quick with my sword because this method does take a little bit long. I don't know if the bomb itself does things. It really just allows you to take advantage of him dropping his weapons, but if it does damage as well, then even better. Twice as much benefit for us. So, keeping that up. And we will be seeing this guy later on if he doesn't come back. I think he's fighting two of these guys at some later point. And they're about. They're even easier then because your sword's been upgraded, so. Yeah, it's a fun time. Let's try doing that tonight again. I almost had this guy defeated, don't you worry. Here soon, I'm gonna try some Skyward strikes. They're fairly good. His helmet just got knocked off, so that means we're nearing completion of this guy. He's almost dead. Cheap shot, little guy. Go ahead and grab some extra health. Go ahead. I'm getting tired of that. He's slashing. He should die. There we go. Alright, that's the end of him. You'll fall down, be dead, and boom. Disappear. That will open this door. We go ahead and grab that. I really wish that it would have just made a chest appear in here so we don't actually have to go through a door. It's kind of a waste of time. Well, let's go ahead and grab this. It's the dungeon item. In this case, it is... whip. Kind of like the whip from Spirit Tracks. Except this one has a little bit more functionality, can attack enemies, can grab items, you can swing, and pull a bunch of different stuff. It's really cool. What you'll notice, you won't really see in this video, in the next video, when I actually start to explore, is that when you whip on something, you actually have to pull back at the right way, otherwise nothing will happen. It's kind of like swing and miss. But anyways, that's pretty much the end of this video. I'm going to go ahead and ride that up, exit the room. Next video, we'll explore deeper into this dungeon. So until next time, don't forget to subscribe for some more Skyward Sword goodness. Bye.